habari zenu. Karibu sana sana katika sherehe hii. Tunawakaribisha wenye mmetoka mbali, mmekuja mapema asubuhi na mapema, na tuna furaha sana sisi kama Kenya Human Rights Commission kuungana na nyinyi katika hii sherehe. Nina mambo ambayo ningependa kusema na nitayasoma kwa lugha ya Kimombo, lakini kwanza kabisa ni kuambia nyote nyinyi kama mashujaa, wengine metoka mbali sana, wengine pengine sio rahisi sana kusafiri kwa safari mrefu, lakini mmejitahidi kufika hapa. Kwa hivyo sisi tunaona vizuri na tunashukuru kwa sababu mmejitolea kuungana na sisi katika hii siku. Alafu sasa nitasoma yale ambayo nimeandika hapa kidogo. In the year 2003, with Dr. Willie Mutunga as Executive Director, the Kenya Human Rights Commission received a request from the Mau Mau War Veterans Association to support victims of the colonial era torture, which took place during Kenya's emergency period of 1952 to 1960. There followed a long period of preparations, at the end of which a decision was made to bring individual test cases of torture against the British government in London. Five claimants were selected, and this led to the filing in 2009 of the case Niku Mutua and four others versus the Commonwealth Office. This is the case prevalently known as the Mau Mau Reparations case. By 2011, when the first hearing occurred in London, one of the claimants had died. After that hearing, the High Court rejected the claimant's argument that the liabilities of the colonial administration transferred to the British government on independence, but also allowed the claimants to proceed on the basis of other arguments. In 2012, the High Court ruled that three of the five cases could proceed, a decision that the British government, as the defendant, was allowed to appeal, and a hearing was set for May 2013. However, in June, just a month before the scheduled hearing, the British government announced that it would settle the case out of court. That on the 12th of September 2015, this memorial was inaugurated in honor of victims of torture and ill treatment during the colonial era. The memorial is called the Memorial to the Victims of Torture and Ill Treatment during the Colonial Era, 1952 to 1963. This memorial has come to be popularly known as the Mau Mau Monument. The commemoration of the memorial is part of the actions towards developing solidarity and mounting united interventions to support, appreciate, and protect Kenyan heroes and heroines who are derived from the various spheres, and all very many of those heroes and heroines are sitting with us today. In this regard, the Kenya High Commission salutes the members and the leadership of the Mau Mau War Veterans Association gathered here today. This event is a recognition of the pain and loss of dignity that you suffered. We thank all of you for the sacrifices that you made for the country. We thank your leadership and Mzee Gituka Hengeri, who is seated on this side, for the exemplary leadership that you've provided to the association. This event is also a platform that will be used to start a conversation around the essence of an intergenerational discourse that would facilitate handovers, impartations, and invitations in the fight for democracy in various multidisciplinary spaces, present and in future. How has the Kenyan public used this memorial? In its 1 year of existence, the memorial has been a place that has symbolically linked the meaning of the Mau Mau freedom struggle, being the site of the late struggles for freedom and democracy in the second liberation of the 1980s and 1990s. The three plaques, and you will see those plaques over there, on the state of emergency, the Mau Mau movement and reconciliation memorialize an important period of Kenyan history and highlight historical facts in detail. Commemoration of the memorial is particularly important for the surviving victims of torture and the Kenyan populace at large, as it epitomizes recognition of the aspirations of the liberation struggle, the sacrifices of past generations, and their goodwill towards their country. The memorial is designed for public use and enjoyment. It provides education through its easily readable plaques that capture history in a simple manner. The sculptures show food being brought to a Maumau fighter by a woman fighter during the freedom struggle in the forest. The edge of the podium is designed as a continuous seat where people can sit and talk as they look at the sculpture and learn from the story of the Maumau engraved on the plaques. This is actually a feature that is common in Swahili architecture. It is called a baraza. The monument has become the most popular place in this park, heavily used throughout its first year. Teachers bring their classes here to learn, and always there are children and young couples engaging with the figures in the sculpture. It is a fun place to be. In the events that led to the shoot in London, in the context of which this memorial was established, Dr. Mutunga played a key role as the director of the Kenya Human Rights Commission, and of course he was succeeded in that role by other directors who have come after him and before me. Dr. Mutunga went on to serve as the Chief Justice of Kenya, a position from which he retired recently. We welcome him here today as a member of the Kenya Human Rights Commission family, and also recognize the special role that he played in the events that we are commemorating today. I would like to thank all those who have played special roles in the events that led to what we are commemorating today. Since the settlement was reached in London, the British government has played a leading role, first paying out the monetary reparations, then in the arrangements that led to the creation of this memorial, and also in the preparations for today's commemoration. We welcome the British High Commissioner, Nick Haley, and through him we convey our thanks to the British government. I would like to add that when it comes to state cooperation with court processes, the conduct of the British government is a source of good example of how governments should behave towards courts of law in situations of litigation. The British government, ever since the settlement, has been most supportive of everything that we've done in relation to the Maumau processes, and we thank you very much for that, and hope that our own government, which is often involved in similar processes in litigation, both at home and abroad, can borrow a leaf from the British government in terms of an ideal behavior by government towards court cases. Moving forward, we would like to make the request that the national government considers publishing the memorial as a national monument in accordance with the relevant law that will facilitate its maintenance and recognition. We hope that Madam Ondimu can go with that message to the Cabinet Secretary. Secondly, there is need for continuous documentation and accurate recording of history that correctly captures the Kenyan liberation narrative. And as the Kenya Human Rights Commission that has been involved in this struggle, and as the Maumau War Veterans Association, our long-standing partner in that process, we hope that in the coming days and months, we will continue documenting the histories, and including the personal struggles that are evident in the general narrative of the Maumau history. Thirdly, there is need to operationalize the Heroes and Heroines Act in order to ensure that we celebrate the exemplary work done by Kenyans in relation to the country. So I hope I again nikimaliza ninasema ya kwamba niwakaribisha sana, tunashukuru sana ya kwamba mmepata nafasi ya kuwa na sisi na tutasherehekea haya makumbusho pamoja kwa siku ya leo. Asanteni.